to the channel. Enjoy the live night streams every Sunday, as well as regular updates sprinkled throughout the week. Hold on to your butts, it's going to be a bumpy ride.
Tells me you're brilliant.
It was brilliant.
Brilliant, Jack. Brilliant.
You're a brilliant conversations man. A trifle limited, but brilliant.
Brilliant.
Years and 7 days ago, Falling Down hit theaters. Initially receiving a polarizing reception from critics and audiences alike, and has since built up a cult following, with positivity outweighing criticism in a big way. Hell, even Siskel and Ebert butted heads over the film.
The subject is legitimate, of course, but Falling Down is more about exploitation scenes of Douglas blown up than any serious investigation of Michael Douglas's psyche. Its script needed another run through the typewriter.
I liked it better than you did, Gene, and I think one element of the picture that you haven't really gotten into is that the movie is really about two middle-class, middle-aged white guys who both feel that their lives have basically been thrown away and were pointless, and one of them is Douglas, and the other one is Duvall.
The story centers almost entirely onto William Foster, later referred to as D-Fens, and is brought to life by well-renowned actor Michael Douglas, and he is traveling through Los Angeles to visit his ex-wife and daughter for his little girl's birthday. Foster is dead focused on that singular goal throughout the movie, yet is often sidetracked by a series of horrible events that present William with constant obstacles along the way. At the same time, Martin Prendergast, played by another incredible actor in Robert Duvall, is a retiring police sergeant, literally working his final day on active duty, as he finds himself tied to investigating the events D-Fens is involved with. Falling Down is one of the best examples I could think of when I tried to define a strong thriller that is riddled with psychological elements and brief pieces of comedy sprinkled throughout.
How's the food? I think we have a critic.
William Foster was a family man before the events leading into the film, ultimately having divorced his spouse, Elizabeth, and the audience naturally empathizes with him as the story progresses, with an understanding that he is returning to his former home simply to see his daughter, Adele, on her birthday. As the story unfolds, we are introduced to certain information that outlines and clarifies William's history of aggressiveness under pressure, his semi-controlled mental instability, and a short temper. Though he gets physically violent several times on screen, the viewer can observe his positive intentions at heart.
What kind of vigilante are you?
I am not a vigilante. I am just trying to get home to my little girl's birthday.
From his brutal assault on Mr. Lee's merchandise, the encounters with a specific gang, the whammy burger scene, the Nazi sympathizer, the golf resort members, the road worker, and I use the word worker loosely, all the way down to the pretentious asshat at the phone booth. Every act of violent behavior is provoked by those opposing Foster, which better helps the audience relate to his emotionally tested character. From the cast, to the cinematography, location design, pacing, musical score, and engaging story, everything about Falling Down is great. And hell, they even nailed the overall atmosphere we are shown from the streets of Los Angeles. And having lived in close proximity for the first 30 plus years of my life, I feel more than comfortable making that statement. And all of these aspects make Falling Down undoubtedly brilliant. What are your thoughts on Falling Down? Leave me a comment below. Don't forget to like the video and share the video with others. It helps me get my name out there and I really appreciate it. And on that note, this is CyberDan and thanks for watching.